Muffin top, spare tire, middle age spread. Whatever you call it, research shows that excess weight around your middle poses a particular threat for heart disease. A 2015 study with over 15,000 participants looked at normal weight individuals with abdominal obesity. They compared them with obese people who didn't carry weight around their middle. They found that those with a higher belly fat had an increased risk of dying from heart disease as well as other causes. A further 2018 study tracked participants for 7 years. They concluded women and men who carried more weight around their waist had a much greater risk of developing heart disease. So why does where we store fat matter? Well, we're about to explore this, as well as uncover our top 6 steps to get rid of belly fat. We'll also uncover the number one food that could be causing excess weight around the middle. Before you get the inside scoop on how to get rid of belly fat, make sure to like this video and subscribe to Heart Disease Code. We've got amazing new content each week. Also, stick around because later in this video, we'll show you how to receive 2 free gifts on us. So why does belly fat increase your risk of heart attacks? Firstly, it's important to note that when fat is stored around your abdomen, this means it is stored around vital organs, such as the liver, pancreas, and your intestines. It appears that this often interferes with insulin sensitivity, blood glucose, blood pressure, blood lipids, and increases fatty acids. Fatty acids then accumulate in the liver, the heart, and other organs, resulting in organs no longer functioning optimally, causing inflammation and greatly increasing the risk of atherosclerosis. So let's get to our top 6 ways to beat the belly bulge. First on our list is de-stress. Did you know that stress can be a huge factor for holding on to belly fat? This can be due to 2 factors. One factor is that it can be caused by a result of high levels of the stress hormone cortisol. The second factor is that stress can induce unhealthy behaviors. And of course, a combination of the two can lead to significant weight gain. But first, let's look at how cortisol can cause weight gain. When under stress, the body releases cortisol, which gets the body into a fight or flight response. But if stress is always present, you can experience an overexposure to cortisol. This is a problem, as cortisol is a significant appetite stimulant. This is why people often respond to stress by going for comfort food. Furthermore, excess calories consumed when cortisol is high seem more likely to be stored as belly fat. One study on women found that those who reported one or more stresses during a previous 24-hour period burned 104 fewer calories than non-stressed women. So how can you overcome stress? Well, this may be the million-dollar question, but with some simple strategies, we can learn to manage our response to stress. And some key ways to do this are engaging in relaxing activities such as walking and stretching. This will aid in increasing blood flow, reducing cortisol, and boosting the feel-good hormones that are released when we move our bodies. If you start to feel stressed, do a few minutes of deep breathing. Take some time out each day to meditate, especially on things you are grateful for. Spend time in nature. And finally, avoid too many stimulants such as caffeine. Next on our list is something associated with stress. Without the right amount of this, you could be sabotaging any weight loss efforts. Can you guess what it is? Number 5, sleep. Poor sleep or too little sleep can certainly make you feel lousy and mess with your daily performance. But what most people don't realize is it can affect your weight too. This is due to the way it increases appetite. When we're sleep deprived, our hormones ghrelin and leptin are affected. Ghrelin is the hormone which kicks in when we're hungry. Leptin is the hormone that tells us that we've eaten enough. Unfortunately, when we're sleep deprived, ghrelin is increased, which leads to us feeling like eating more. And leptin production is decreased, so that feeling of being full isn't signaled to the brain as efficiently. On top of this, when we're sleep deprived, our metabolism is not working to its full capacity, which means we're more likely to gain weight. Now the question is, what can we do to improve sleep? Firstly, the number one thing is to prioritize getting good quality and enough sleep. This can be done by creating habits, such as turning off bright lights a couple of hours before bedtime. Limit blue light exposure in the evenings. Try downloading a free blue light blocking software onto your devices. Avoid caffeine in the late afternoon. Limit alcohol consumption, which can also disturb sleep. Try having a relaxing bath and candlelight just before bed. Also, having the right sleep environment is key for quality sleep. To optimize your sleep, ensure your bedroom is dark, quiet, free from devices, and keep the room around 65 Fahrenheit. Now for our fourth way of reducing belly fat, which is intermittent fasting. Unless you've been living under a rock for the last few years, you will have no doubt heard about intermittent fasting, or IF for short. Intermittent fasting flies in the face of conventional wisdom of eating little and often. Proponents of intermittent fasting claim it decreases the hormone insulin. When insulin is reduced, it allows our body to use its fat stores, whereas with eating little and often, our body is releasing much more insulin. Thus, our body doesn't use up its stored energy and burn fat. According to studies and anecdotal evidence, the benefits of intermittent fasting include lowered insulin and blood sugar levels, possible reversal of type 2 diabetes, increased clarity and mental focus, improved energy levels, reduction of inflammation, and of course, weight loss. So how do you go about intermittent fasting? Well, the best way to start is to stop eating a few hours before bed and wait to eat a couple of hours after you've woken up. This will give you a 12-hour fasting period, which should be achievable for most people. Once you're doing this regularly and feel comfortable doing it, you can go for longer stretches. Next, try 14 hours and then 16 hours. Then you may want to try a 24-hour fast once a week. Please consult your healthcare practitioner before extended fasting periods, especially if you're taking medications. Many people have had great results of reducing weight and blood sugar using intermittent fasting, so why not give it a try? Next, we're about to uncover an often overlooked aspect of weight gain, as well as explain how one type of food could be blocking your weight loss efforts. But first, if you can't get enough of these tips for blasting off belly fat and reducing your risk of heart attack, then why not download our free ebook, The Surprising Truth About Fat and Cholesterol? And if you'd really like to understand the full picture for fighting and preventing heart disease, check out episode 1, The Untold Story of Heart Disease. Both gifts are free and waiting for you now. Just click the link below in the description. Now for number 3, gut health. You may not think that this influences your weight, but studies have shown that it does. One study, looking at the link between gut bacteria and obesity, took a cohort of 77 sets of twins. From each set of twins, one was obese and the other in a normal weight range. The researchers found that obesity was associated with lower gut bacteria diversity. This means there were fewer types of gut bacteria in the obese twin. A further study on 292 participants discovered that those who were overweight also had lower gut diversity and higher markers of inflammation. In our gut alone, we have 30 trillion bacteria. These play a crucial role in our health and how our body digests our food. If we aren't feeding them a diverse range of whole foods, certain bad ones can overgrow and beneficial ones can become scarce. This can lead to nutritional deficiencies and long-term can lead to weight gain. So how do these bacteria affect our weight? Firstly, as we've mentioned already, our body produces hormones that tell our brain when we are hungry and full. However, it appears that different bacteria can affect how much of our hormones are produced. This can cause us to overeat. Secondly, gut bacteria can affect our body's ability to absorb nutrients. Without getting the right amount of nutrients, we can become nutrient deficient. This can then lead to cravings and a feeling of never being satisfied after eating, causing us to eat more in order to feel full. Another key to the role of gut health and weight gain is that certain bacteria, if at a high level, can produce something called lipopolysaccharide, or LPS for short. When this chemical is produced, especially in excess amounts, it can get into the blood. This can cause our body to get into a state of inflammation. When we're inflamed, this can promote weight gain and insulin resistance. However, other strains of bacteria can actually reduce inflammation. Therefore, creating an environment where the good bugs thrive is a key part of blasting off belly bulge. So how can we do this? One way is by eating prebiotics. Prebiotics feed the good bacteria, allowing them to overtake the bad. These can be found in foods such as garlic, onions, legumes, oats, buckwheat, boiled potatoes that have been cooled, as well as a wide range of other plant foods. Also, adding strains of bacteria into our gut increases the good bacteria growth. This can be done through encapsulated probiotics and fermented foods, such as sauerkraut, yogurt, kombucha, and kefir. Finally, eating a wide range of plant foods will provide your body with the fiber that will help reduce inflammation associated with abdominal obesity. And this, of course, leads me to my number two tip to beat belly fat, that is, eating a plant-based diet. One of the key reasons to eat a diet that is predominantly plants is that it helps to reduce inflammation. One of the key things about belly fat is that it's highly inflammatory. Researchers from the Washington University School of Medicine have confirmed that fat cells inside the abdomen are secreting molecules that increase inflammation. Decreasing inflammation can help reduce excess weight, thus lower the risk of the conditions associated with obesity. Not only are plants low calorie, high in fiber, but they're also rich in nutrients that will help reduce inflammation. Research suggests that people who eat primarily plant-based diets tend to have a lower body mass index, lower rates of obesity, diabetes, heart disease, than those who eat diets based on meat. Eating this way ensures that we give our body a wide variety of nutrients. This reduces the risk of nutritional deficiencies and the cravings that come along with them. Plants also help to create a healthy gut, which, as we've already discussed, can help support reduction in belly fat. Another key thing about plants is that they contain a type of antioxidant called polyphenols. Polyphenols help to feed our good bacteria. This in turn will improve our hormone signaling, increasing the feeling of fullness. It's also thought that polyphenols can improve digestion issues, weight management, diabetes, neurodegenerative disease, and of course, cardiovascular diseases. We're about to unveil the most crucial thing to avoid if you want to get rid of excess weight around your middle. But first, if you can't get enough of these tips for blasting belly fat and reducing your risk of heart attacks, then why not download our free ebook, The Surprising Truth About Fat and Cholesterol. And if you'd really like to understand the full picture for fighting and preventing heart disease, check out episode 1 of The Untold Story of Heart Disease. Both gifts are free and waiting for you now. Just click the link below in the description. Our number one key to reducing abdominal fat is to avoid processed sugar and flour. When it comes to getting the body you want, eating foods that are highly processed could be the very thing that prevents you from reaching your goals. Did you know that when we eat refined flours and sugar, it causes a release of dopamine, the feel-good hormone, in our brains? Our brains are wired to want this feel-good hormone, so we create habits where we look for our next dopamine hit. More often than not, this comes in the form of a donut, candy bar, pizza, or whatever processed food your taste buds crave. Now don't go thinking you're just weak-willed and can't lose weight. I'd like to say it's actually quite the opposite. Why? Well, studies have shown that sugar or processed flour are just as addictive as cocaine. A number of experiments on rats have shown that when given cocaine for a period of time, to the point that they are heavily addicted, they'll still choose a hit of sugar over cocaine when given the choice. Crazy, right? Also, countless studies have investigated the role that gut bacteria play in food addiction. On a diet high in processed foods, we can create a microbiome with bacteria that thrive on sugar. These bacteria have the ability to create cravings in the brain, causing us to eat even more sugar. But if we eat healthy, whole foods that are low in sugar, we can develop a healthy microbiome. Furthermore, sugar and flours are highly inflammatory. This is the reason they're more likely to create fat around your middle. So removing these foods from your diet will enable you to reduce inflammation, create a more robust immune system, improve cardiovascular health, and of course, help get rid of excess belly fat. So there you have our 6 surprising ways to get rid of belly fat and create a heart-healthy body. Make sure to stay tuned to Heart Disease Code to discover more wonderful nutrition and wellness insights. And once again, don't leave without grabbing both of your 2 free gifts. Just click the link below. Thanks for watching and have a heart-healthy day.